At the age of 16, I didn't have dreams. I didn't have hope. For me, I felt like I would be lucky if I lived past 18.
Halfway through my sophomore year, I ended up being pregnant. I got pregnant at 17.
The people behind are just gonna leave them behind. And that was me. I was left behind. Find a chair.
My name is Matthew Rodriguez. I'm the principal of Albizu Campos Puerto Rican High School. All of our students who come to our school are considered, they're labeled as what's called a dropout.
Which part of our group right now is prepared to have the top GPA in the month of October? Which one's the labeled?
In the traditional public education model, what the teachers and what the administrators were doing was saying, well, it's clear to us that these young people don't care about their education. It's clear to us that they're lazy. They don't want to do their homework. They don't want to do their assignments. It's clear to us that their parents don't really have education as a value. It's clear to us that their community doesn't care about education.
When they're leaving, I felt like school was ended for me. I was like, man, you know what? I'm pregnant. There's nothing I can do. I'm going to be another statistic that's going to be, you know, be another statistic, you know, dropped out of school, pregnant.
They come into our school with the feeling of this inferiority complex. I can't learn fast enough like everyone else. I don't understand. I'm dumb. I can't do this.
At my old school, it was like, if you didn't care, they didn't care, you know? So it was like, if you didn't want to pay attention, they weren't going to pay attention to you.
How did the Spaniards feel about the Taino priest?
That he was nothing?
Explain.
What they do is they take the amount of time that needs to be taught. They take the amount of instruction that needs to be there, and those remain constant. And what happens is learning varies. And what the creators of Albizu Campos believed is that equation was wrong. In fact, what needs to vary is the amount of time that students have to be able to learn a concept, the amount of instruction that a teacher provides, so that way the constant is learning.
One of the biggest differences that I like the most about this school is that it's smaller. So every student gets the attention that they really deserve and need, and they focus more on you and the individual abilities that each student has and how we're all different.
Our young people in the 70s and even now have to face not having parents in the household, whether because they're incarcerated or because they're in rehab or because they just are not there. We have young people who are in their homes and have to negotiate space because they have two and three and four families living in one household, and it's difficult to know where they're going to be sleeping at night, where they're going to be getting their food in the morning, where they're going to be able to have their clean clothes to go to school the next day.
The supports and services that we offer for our youth come based on those very experiences, those very challenges that our students face.
If they notice that we're failing, they take us out. Hey, you know what? Come on, I need to talk to you. 15, 20 minutes to figure out what's going on with us. They keep us on track. They call us. If they need to send an email out, hey, man, this student, something's going on with the student. She's feeling she was doing good, and now she's losing track.
Instead of saying, you're absent, bad student, you need to be in school, we say, well, what's going on? Why are you choosing to stay home? If we listen, we'll hear what the reasons are, and then we have what we need in order to prepare our interventions appropriately.
One of the things that also sets our school apart is that we have a different kind of curriculum.
As a school founded by and still working in the Puerto Rican community, we are dead set on making sure that our cultural history, our people's history is preserved and passed on.
It's about how you make that lesson relate to that student's life and allow it to relate to their experiences and what they believe their future can be. Albizu Campos did that greatly for us. For the first time, we felt like we were the individuals in the books. Like when the teacher was lecturing to us, they're lecturing about us.
In addition to all of the standardized testing, there's this rigorous process in our school called the senior portfolio process, where the students have to defend their right to graduate. They can do that by showing grades, by showing progress in a class, by showing examples of work for different classes. They can do that by being able to show their involvement in community activities.
I'm involved in 72 Block by Block, which is a diabetic empowerment center, which I help with other patients who are diabetic. I counsel them. I help them with like taking their, you know, their pressure.
So it's a comprehensive view of who the student is at that point in their life.
Last year, we had a retention rate of 73%, whereas in the larger public school system, you have a retention rate of between 54 and 55%. Of our senior class last year, 80% were scheduled to be involved with college or post-secondary placement. We have an attendance rate of about 82%. And again, these are students who, for whatever reason, right, in their previous schools, never came to school, had 50, 55 days absent, who are now coming to Albizu Campos and celebrating perfect attendance every month.
When a student clicks, when it clicks, and they say, I can, you know, and sometimes it's I can for the very first time in their educational experience, I can do this. I can be successful. I can go to college. I can get an A in that class. And it just shoots from there, you know? It's really beautiful to be able to witness.
I graduated with a bachelor's degree in justice studies. I walk in December at Northeastern Illinois University, but I have plans to go into UIC and go into the field of education.
I love everything about the school, everything about it. Like, now I am an honors, like, I'm basically honors. I have been having straight A's for almost a half a year now. I had perfect attendance for a year, half a year already.
I'm on the basketball team, and I'm also in a Pana Council representative. So I'm doing those activities now. I stay after school for study hall and just keep my grades up there and, you know, be on the basketball team.
There's a generation of young people now who are going to college, who are doing the things that they need to do because they believe in a greater picture. They believe that it's all possible for them now.